Some DFW Republicans in the House joined Democrats in voting to increase the direct payments. It'll be a tougher test in the Senate as President Trump adds pressure on Republicans.
What does the COVID-19 relief bill mean for you in North Texas? If you are one of many who are unemployed, the bill extends unemployment benefits and gives an additional $300 weekly. Last week, more than 59,000 Texans filed a new unemployment claim. President Trump signed the bill Sunday, but because he held it for multiple days, those unemployment checks will be delayed by about a week.
There is going to be an interruption. And I know that people are going to try to brace themselves as best as they can. But when you look at the record long food lines that we have here in Dallas-Fort Worth, at the area food banks, it didn't have to happen.
The relief bill adds money to the payroll protection program to help small businesses. The bill gives everyone $600 direct payments. Reports from the Treasury Department say those checks could be sent as early as the end of this week. Last week, Republican Senator Ted Cruz and Representatives Michael Burgess of Denton and Van Taylor of Plano voted against the bill. Then President Trump demanded Congress increase direct payments to $2,000. The U.S. House agreed with the increase Monday night. All Democrats from North Texas voted to increase direct payments. Republican Representative Kay Granger from Fort Worth and Michael Burgess from Denton voted yes. Representative Van Taylor from Plano voted no. Burgess, who voted against the relief bill signed by the president, explained why he supported the larger checks on Fox and Friends.
There needs to be more money to Americans. I agree with that. I agree with the president on that. I think he's exactly correct. I voted against the bill last week because I thought it was too big and too many moving parts, too difficult for people to comprehend. And the final analysis, there really wasn't the help to the American people that the president had envisioned.
Representative Taylor said in a statement about his vote today, saying, quote, Congress should target assistance so that those who had their employment and wages affected are the ones who receive the help. Representative VC of Arlington says now the pressure is on Senate Republicans to align with the president.
They have an opportunity to actually stand by him when he's, you know, trying to do something that could actually help people. So let's see, do they really care about people during this pandemic? They're going to have an opportunity to show if they truly care or not.
The Senate reconvenes tomorrow, but it's no word on when the bill will come up for a vote or debate.